Tao De Wang was the founder and chairman of the Fuyao Group, the largest auto glass manufacturer in China and the fastest growing and second largest auto glass manufacturer in the world. As chairman, Mr. Tao set Fuyao's strategy, including its financial strategy and dividend policy.
因为呢，我是这个企业的董事长，也就是说掌门人。那董事长跟总经理的根本性的区别，因为我必须要管经营战略上的制定。意思是说，你问我那个做事的风格的话呢，我可能更注重于平常人更注重于宏观面的东西的研究。 那根据宏观这个现象来判断整个经济走向，那再根据在经济走向呢，我来制定投资的战略，就是说我在集团里面的主要做的事情，就是研究我要在什么时候做什么，由谁来做，做多大，这是我定的。 我主要是做这项工作，那么这个定完以后呢，我交给我们下面的，叫他们去做。那具体的我们不管，我具体的下面人管，就是我们分得很清楚。我们董事会，我董事长呢是决策层呢，就是决策负责研究做什么。我的管理层呢，他在执行我的决策的时候，他在研究怎么做。
Fuyao was established in 1987 by domestic, foreign, private, and local government interests to produce replacement windshields for the after-sales domestic Chinese automobile repair market. Although legally a Chinese foreign joint venture, Fuyao was essentially a privately owned and operated company under the control of Mr. Cao. Fuyao evolved from the Fuching County Gaoshan special-shaped glass factory, established in 1983 to make glass water meters and run by Mr. Cao on contracts that he negotiated with local government. These gave Mr. Cao residual profits after payment of dividends to the local government. How did Mr. Cao, a man born into extreme poverty in the Fuyao countryside, come to run a growing glass factory? His parents provided seminal influence. Mr. Cao's mother taught him, in poverty, be pure. In wealth, be clear. Stand straight and hold your head high. Don't let others look down on you. A true man is wholesome. The most important thing is to earn the trust of others. His father, who lived in Japan before the revolution, had no knowledge of farming, but his private business in the tobacco trade in Fujian brought the Cao family prosperity in the early years after the communist liberation of China. The young Cao learned that a vibrant market was inseparable from business. The family business, however, could not last. The government collectivized all businesses and reduced the family to poverty. Mr. Cao, while still a fifth grade student, had to leave school to become a laborer. Mr. Cao reflected on lessons learned from his father.
Although my dad was bright and knew how to do business, he was only a small trader. The government took it away. There was absolutely no future in it. I was young. I wasn't going to follow the old road of my father. Once I was independent, I would do what the government permitted, and I would learn how to make money from it.
On a road construction site where he went to work, Cao noticed that progress was being held up by damaged carts. He persuaded the foreman to let him repair the carts.
On the roadside, at the number 6 Gaoshan site, I set up in a shed and wrote a sign, Gaoshan Cart Repairs. Launching my cart repair career. I did not get any payment for repairing the carts. From the time when I started figuring out how to repair carts through to becoming an expert repairman, it took me 28 days, during which I never took one step away from my repair shed.
Mr. Cao's service attitude and sensitivity to community and government needs helped him to establish under the Gaoshan Commune a water meter glass factory. He attributed his success partly to the attention he paid to accounting.
If it had not been for the accounting that I'd learned from the commune's chief accountant, Mr. Chun, when difficulties came up at the factory and the commune asked me to take it over, I never would have had the management accounting foundation needed to run it. Even more, I never would have had the ability to read financial statements and, through them, understand the conditions of the factory.
Mr. Cao, understanding the need for technology, approached friends in Shanghai to transfer technology from a large, well-established, state-owned glass factory in Shanghai, Yaohua Glass, to his small water meter glass factory. Yaohua responded by sending a young female engineer who was highly competent and decisive.
At that time, I didn't realize that the slim Shanghainese young lady would play the manly role of becoming our technology pillar. In 1984, the roads of South China were crowded with cars, mostly imported and privately owned. Whatever brand, they were cheap to buy, a few tens of thousands of renminbi. But if the windshield broke, replacing it was a real problem, because there was no domestic supplier of windshields, and importing them was really expensive. So at that time, you'd see, it didn't matter whether it was a car, an off-road vehicle, a commercial vehicle, a bus, or a truck. They would often have a broken windshield, which would be repaired with tape. The front, back, or side windows. Not only was it ugly, it was unsafe. Why was there no domestic producer?
Mr. Cao saw the opportunity.
If others wouldn't do it, I would do it. For China, I would make our own auto glass that all Chinese people could use happily and safely. Looking back, I see that in an enterprise, the goal is critical. Only if the direction is correct can the enterprise succeed.
Mr. Cao was as good as his word. The 18 years following 1987 saw Fuyao Glass achieve its aim to become China's leading auto glass producer. In 1993, Fuyao Glass was listed on the Shanghai Stock Exchange. In 1994, it started actively developing business in Hong Kong and the U.S. Fuyao's entry into international markets, selling auto glass at highly competitive prices, led foreign competitors to charge Fuyao with dumping and foreign governments to impose anti-dumping duties. Fuyao responded by vigorously contesting dumping allegations. In 2002, Canada's International Commercial Court judged that Fuyao's sales in Canada did not constitute dumping. In 2003, Fuyao integrated upstream by producing its own float glass. In 2013, Fuyao invested abroad by constructing an auto glass production facility in Kaluga Oblast, Russia. The following year, Fuyao acquired from PPG a float glass manufacturing facility at Mount Zion, Illinois, the United States. But perhaps Mr. Cao's greatest international personal triumph was his being named the Ernst & Young Entrepreneur of the Year 2009, the first time a Chinese entrepreneur had received that award, and a resounding endorsement of his management philosophy. Mr. Cao based his principles of management on his early experiences and learned at every opportunity with humility and determination. In the process, he developed Fuyao's set of financial guidelines. First, his views on debt.
因此我认为做企业呢，不能够说不负债，不负债是傻瓜做的。那应该负债，那多少和你呢？五十以下是合理的。有的人更保守一点，三十以下。管得好一点呢，五十以下。因为我现在还在董事长位置上面，我还在监管他们呢。因此我认为五十以下没有问题，因为他现在这个做的产品很特别。 现金流很充裕，我跟你讲呢，在我的理念里面，我认为像我们这个重资产的企业，就是制造业，它的负债率呢，应该是合理的，负债呢应该在50%以下都算合理，50%以下是合理的，那超过50%是不合理的。 那我为什么前面我会有66%呢？我不是不知道这里有风险，我知道。
Because his view of Fuyao's debt capacity is tempered by what he sees as his responsibility as controlling shareholder of Fuyao to guarantee the company's health, because he implicitly guarantees the company, he believes that it has higher debt capacity.
如果说万一碰到危机，因为他我们非要集团是很多单体在里面，那我会出来救，大股东出来承担责任，会叫集团呢重组，卖掉他几个公司的套现，那由我个人来买，我可以把我的公司在香港抵押成现金来帮他救下来，对不对？ 原来是用这个来保护集团，因为是很高负债经营。因为我认为呢，高负债经营是企业的利润的主要来源。因为现在各国政府都在搞 QE 宽松货币政策，只要你认为项目是正确的，你投资是可行的，举债是利润。这个工厂今年建跟明年建呢？ 差20%，利息才付多少？对不对？这样的概念。
He sees benefits in borrowing in different currencies to take advantage of lower interest rates.
利率高跟低呢？像俄罗斯卢布4%现在，我也借卢布，因为利息高就说明货币软，借它可能更合算，明白吗？就这么简单了，这个不是关键。
If you ask Mr. Cao whether the cash flows of Fuyao are stable, his answer is without doubt.
非常的稳定，因为我才很牛逼的时候，我每年拿50%的利润分红，分了有来有去，就这样的分。因为不分你全部还给银行，我股东就不合算了。这企业是股东的，你为什么不负债呢？ 负债经营，我跟你讲，几个好处呢。第一个，负债的资金成本可以在税前列支，不要交所得税，对吧？第二个呢，每一个国家都在宽松货币政策，他们超印的钞票不知道印多少，你跟着他瞎猜什么，是不是？第三个，作为我们投资者来说，也应该享受我们投资成功分一点红利回去，宽松一点也过好日子。
But even with stable cash flows, the
dividend payout is considerable.
The dividend policy of Fuyao is influenced by its investment opportunities.
汽车玻璃方面，在中国都投了，到国外去投，我们整个行情有没有了解清楚？了解清楚了才下手，对不对？在中国已经都已经建好了，没有地方可以再建了，清楚吗？因此我投资停了，投资停了，那么钱拿来干什么？ 当然拿来分了，那么把负债率跟他降到50%以下，我跟年轻人讲呢，你们很安全，不需要我保你了。因为他我跟他算过，他有大量的现金流进来，分红都是当年赚的钱拿去分红。他如果公司的资金有去向，有地方投资。 那我们就不会发鼓励，发那么多给他。那没有地方投资，必须拿出来分，让股东拿到好处。因为企业不负债，不行的，那个是不健康的企业。因为你平常就是能够过日子的话，也要跟银行建立一个信用记录啊。以后你是要钱的时候才可以借到钱啊，你说是不是？是这样做的。 那现在。 举步往国外跨出去了，俄罗斯建好了，美国正在建，那美国项目又投40亿钱，不是30亿，我们今年在美国花了2亿9000万美金了，还后面呢下半年还要更大力度的再花美国的钱，再投资美国。 这是福耀全球化战略的一个重要一步，对吧？是这个问题。那我们现在这个作为将来发展，我们会是美国本土的最大的汽车玻璃厂。那肯定要扩张性，一次性也投不了那么多。要一个需要扩张的过程。我一年。 现金流盈余大概有好几亿美金，那如果不增发股票的话，我只要缩小分红比例就可以了吗？
In determining any dividend policy, it's natural to ask whether the owners of the company's stock have a preference for receiving cash dividends or future investment returns. As the controlling shareholder, Mr. Cao's personal tastes and the tastes of other shareholders are critical.
那我自己也喜欢钱，我那个做了80%的部分，我去哪里拿钱？我在这里工作当董事长，我在这里，我拿的工资呢很少，一年拿几万美金，只够我个人开支。那我老婆孩子是一样的，也要靠分红。Does
the Heren Foundation, a major shareholder of Fuyao, also influence the dividend policy?
在我的心中，最重要的是福耀集团，这是我一生的心血，我的事业。这个核能基金是我捐赠给他的钱，中国人承认我捐了他35亿钱，因为我交股票发给他那一天价是35亿，听懂吗？ 他如果缺钱，可以把股票拿去卖。我没有义务保证他的分红。Mr.
Cao reflects on the difference between running the Heren Foundation and running Fuyao.
我做慈善也要自己下手，比如讲，我在这个我的家乡捐了大概4亿5000万多少钱嘛，大概相当于7000万美金。 建了一个学校和寺庙，在建的2年多3年时间，我每一次出差回来，到时差一早就会跑到那个寺庙去看他的工地，因为从规划设计、发包到基建的建筑，也是跟我建工厂一样的那么认真，对吧？ 但是我也没有专门说，我抄多少时间给他，就反正我有挤一挤，要做好生意的同时，要兼善到他的工程的质量保证，就这样做。做慈善，从我个人来说，只是培养自己的一种境界，一种素质。做企业，我是为了。 谋求生计，就生活依靠在这里做。除我以外，还有我的全体员工需要生活，是吧？那么在谋求这个生计的话，不管是做慈善或者做生计的时候，都应该考虑到尊重社会，在做利益社会的利益国家的情况的下面来实现你的愿望。 那不管做慈善，还是做生意，牵扯到钱拿出来花，或者筹备到钱拿去跟谁，都需要一个项目监管的问题，这个是相同的。
Mr. Cao reflects on the source of his success at Fuyao Glass. He concludes that success, above all, is built on trust. Trust between employer and employee, between suppliers and buyers, between the government and the firm, and within oneself.
员工喜欢找一个好的企业，这个生产环境好，老板受社会尊重的，老板就是受社会尊重，首先是会尊重。产业有前景的，这样的地方，他喜欢在找这样的地方工作，对不对？那么你要去根据他的喜欢，你要去找塑造这个企业，这个第一个条件。第二个条件的话呢，他能够在这里找到适应他个人专业的工作，对吧？那么如果他找他是这个专业，一下子进来的时候能够适应是不可能的，要通过我们帮他培训。 帮他共同的来探讨他的职业生涯的规划怎么样就到他的位置上面去，啊，来帮他一起来探索你做些什么位置。第三个呢，这里呢，我始终把我的员工看作是自己的子女，从德育、体育、智育，从他的这个家庭生活。
Trust is also important with suppliers and subcontractors.
All people have troubles. The same is true of companies. So companies should help each other. From the view of the supply chain, the relationship between suppliers and buyers is purchasing and sales. But it's more than that. The links in the supply chain are not independent. For Fuyao to develop healthily, we don't just need the buyers of our products to be prosperous, we need our suppliers to prosper. You must remember, I am the boss and you work for me. But I won't let you lose money. Should you suffer and I laugh? Should I build my joy on your misery? I'm not that kind of person.
Mr. Cao reflects on management style and on his life.
我们叫充分授权，那么把任何事情呢，就是充分授权呢，真的明确，那么考核到位，讲真会明，他如果考核不合格，就是干掉，这样子讲。Looking
back at my life, my prime years of my life I've given to China's automobile glass. Looking back along the road, every stage, every experience, each picture, each dialogue seems like a scene in a movie played out on my stage of life. Exciting and full of philosophy, nothing is permanent, yet we find meaning and value in following our ancestors' pursuit of development and helping the world.